This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of Watch Me Work on Azrael, the Dark Angel's Grand Master. Although I'm not technically working on Azrael, I'm working on his base. And not even his base, the Watcher's base. I let the Black Wash dry. By the way, if you didn't watch the last video, I washed over the black squares of our marble base with a black wash. And I've let it dry. And to be honest with you, a couple hours later here, it actually looks really, really good. If I cover some of the light up, you can see a really cool contrast there between the dark tiles and the light tiles. The only thing that I notice coming back into this thing is that the black tiles or the dark tiles need a little bit more veining in them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some very, very, very thin paint here and I'm just going to make some very thin lines. I don't want to do a lot of thick stuff, but I do want some thin, just gentle flowing kind of streaks cutting through some of this marbling here. So in some of these darker areas, just want to get a little bit of extra movement here with the veins. What am I trying to say? All right. Come on, make a vein. Jeepers. It's acting like a jerk, not doing what I want it to do. That's because I don't have my paint mixture correct. There we go. Okay, maybe a little bit more kind of up in this one. And we may be close to calling it finished. Maybe just a little bit kind of in this area here. A little vein coming out of that small vein there. There we go. And then maybe a little bit in here some. Maybe right in there. And maybe a little bit kind of in this area here, maybe. And maybe a little coming this way. There we go. Okay, so now
that looks a little better. Now they got a slightly more marbled appearance to them.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is apply another black wash, this time even thinner than previous. Although I'm going to switch palettes because apparently the last time that I did this, I didn't realize it, but I had a crack in my plate. And when I had a crack in my plate, I now have black water on my desk. That's okay. So let's put him in frame so you guys can watch that momentarily. And I am going to take a little bit of this black and just drip it right there. No more than a pinhead size because I don't need that much. And then we'll just make ourselves a very, very, very thin wash because the paint that I just applied is very thin anyway. It's almost transparent, or translucent, really. And so I really don't want, I don't want to cover it up with a heavy wash. Plus, I've already washed the rest of the areas of the black squares in a wash. So coming back and doing it again is going to dull that stuff down just a little bit as well. And it's already kind of in a good tone. Don't really need to go much darker. Oh, by the way, I added in the grout off camera. I got bored and was kind of waiting for things to dry. I thought, you know what, they're dry enough, I could probably add in the grout and not have it spill over onto the tiles. And it worked fairly well, although I will go back and apply another coat because you can definitely see through it, which is a little unfortunate. Okay. There we go. Alright. So we'll call that one temporarily done. So what I'm going to do now is set that one to the side, and we'll pull this other one out that is actually Azrael's base, and we will go back to the beginning. And that means that I need to bend over and get my plate once again for the other color. Okay, there we go. And let's see here. I'm going to take, I gotta make the other color again, because it's kind of dry. So, let us dump some azure onto the plate. That's probably good enough for now. Okay. I gotta tell you, doing this marble stuff is fun. I mean, really, a ton of fun. If you've never done marble before, I would encourage you to give it a shot. And like I said, I learned how to do it by reading internet tutorials. Specifically one tutorial that was head and shoulders above the rest, and that was Laszlo Jakuzowski's tutorial on how to paint marble. It used to be available on hotlead.com or .org or .net or something like that. I'm assuming it's still there. It's been years since I've looked at that site. But a lot of the old painting websites from the late 90s, early 2000s are still active. Well, maybe not active, but they're still out there for people to see. So if you're interested in learning some old school techniques that still work really freaking well today, feel free to check some stuff out. All right, so set that there. Now we're going to get some of this, y'all. And we're gonna drop the base. That's what we're gonna do. For Pete's sake. Now I gotta bend over and pick it up. There it is. Okay. So we are on camera, my friends. Alright, so I'm just gonna kinda do the same crap that I did last time. That's a little bit too dark, isn't it? I think it is. Just a hair. It's alright. I'll go next to it. There's a little bit lighter blue right there. So let's cover that up with some lighter blue. Okay, there we go. And again, we just want to make some thin streaks. You don't want too many of these things in here, but you want enough to where it looks like you've got some veining. And remember, you're going to be coming in and doing several layers of this if you do it. Yeah, it looks like a basketball. Okay, do a little there, maybe some there, a little bit here, a little more, a little bit in there, kind of coming down that way, a little bit streaking in there. All right, and then maybe a drop or two right there, maybe one more right there. Okay. There's that. Okay. Now that I know it works, I can go a little faster. So that's kind of nice. I'm just going to add a little more white to this. Just to make it a little bit lighter. And then we're going to mix it up. Emphasis on a little bit lighter. Jeez. I will bet you that I probably won't be able to tell the difference in these two colors when I put it on the base here. But who knows? I could be wrong, right? Okay, just, again, kind of attacking the base. Remember, all these squares that are still white are going to be black eventually, so I don't really have to worry about getting color on them too much. That's nice. Okay. Just roughing it in. Nothing major as far as rhyme or reason to what I'm doing. Alright. A little more white, a little more water. That's better. Okay. Water in the main brush. Pick some of this up, wipe most of it off. And we'll do the
this, I don't know, one or two more times, who knows. I really want to get rid of that big blue streak right there. I mean, it's not that bad, but it is sort of annoying. It's kind of right in the way. Let's get some actual paint on the brush, and there we go. That pretty much gets rid of it. Okay, now I'm just kind of attacking the squares with just a little bit of color. I think I went a little too dark here, but that's okay. It's not going to kill anything. I will fake it. Okay, now, it's not bad. What I'm going to do, I'm going to go back to the sponge, and I'm just going to pick up a little bit of color on the sponge. I'll just pick a spot here. I tell you what, let me make it a little bit lighter, just a hair lighter than we are right now. And that way we'll cover up some of this major darkness that we put into here. I'm not going to cover it up completely, but we'll give us a little bit of extra, just a little bit of extra spotting in some of this area that we need it in. So let's take maybe this corner here and just dab that into the paint and then dab it off on my paper towel. Then we'll come back and we'll something like that. That does help some. Okay. Alright. Okay, that's not bad. It's very similar to what I've got on this one here. Okay. So let's take some black now, and we'll let me go to a different palette so I don't jack this one up and get black paint everywhere. Pull this palette up here that I just made the wash on. And we'll dip a little black paint out here. Oh, wow, this black paint's almost done for. In fact, I think it's seen its last drop. Do I have any more black? I know I do. Do I have any black in the same brand? That's a different story. Yes, I do. Exciting. Alright. Alright, so I'm just going to go ahead and mix up a semi-thick layer of paint here. And see what kind of damage I can do here. Blarb. There's that. Painting mostly with the side of my brush, that way the paint doesn't go down into the cracks and crevices, although it doesn't really matter because I haven't made it to the grout on this one yet. Alright, 14 minutes in. I don't know how much more of this I'm going to get done, because I've got to let this black dry before I can really do anything with it. So what I'll probably end up doing is breaking right after I finish painting this on. Although the black is drying pretty quickly up there, but I feel like I would like to add another layer of it just to make sure that it is completely covered. So maybe we can do that. Maybe it'll dry fast enough for me to add a secondary layer. But I think we've made some good progress here. We finished up one of the bases, essentially, for the most part.
at some point in the future, after it's all said and done, I'll have to come back in and gloss varnish it to give it that real shiny marble look. What I am going to do, though, is pop this one off the base. Not really pop, but tear very slowly. And put this one down, that way I can ring the base. And I need a different brush for this. The brush I'm using is a little on the small side. It's really meant for the veins, not for the main, not for the main base itself. So let's use a little bit bigger brush. Although I should probably use an even larger one than this, but this is the one that I've chosen, and it'll work, I suppose. And again, you can use this same technique. Again, this is not really meant to be a tutorial, but if you were following along and you learned the marble technique, you can use the same technique to create any color marble you want. I mean, it doesn't have to be black and white. It can be green, red, blue, purple, orange, brown. It doesn't matter. The technique's the same for everything. In fact, I wonder what it would have looked like had I actually done a red marble base. That was my initial intention, honestly, was thinking about doing red marble. But I have to admit that my only real reasoning for picking red was because it contrasts so well with the green, and I thought the green armor of the Dark Angel might work exceptionally well with a red base, but it would just look so weird to have red marble. So I decided to go with a nice, traditional, fancy, black and white marble. And I think, to be honest with you, I think it's going to work extraordinarily well. It's coming out quite nicely, far better than I had anticipated. And I'm looking forward to actually getting both of the miniatures onto these bases and painted up appropriately. Went over a hair right there, but that's okay. It's not going to kill anything, I don't think. It shouldn't kill anything. I hope it doesn't. Let's see. That's pretty darn similar. Let's see if I can balance that one in my hand real quick. There we go. Okay, so if I cover that up. There we go. Okay. Not bad. Not bad at all. Alright. So, let me get a little bit more black here. That's not the right black. Maybe I don't have another black. Yeah, I do. Is this one even open? Let's see. Nope, that one's not open. Do I have an open black somewhere? That's another. That's definitely not the color I wanted. This is the one. That one's not open either. Good job, Christopher. Alright, so every black that I have is sealed tight. That's fantastic. And I don't feel like pulling out a paper clip to poke through them and get them to open up. But we'll get there next time then, I suppose. For right now, though, let's just call it a video. I think it's a pretty good stopping point, and hopefully you guys have enjoyed yourselves as much as I have. I think this is a lot of fun, and I think we've created something that's just really, really darn freaking cool, and I think in the end this is going to look absolutely stunning. I'm going to cover that light up just a little bit. So cool, so cool. Anyway, I want to thank you guys very, very much for watching. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to put those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already. Thank you once again for watching. God bless you all. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.